show you how we are going to do catheterization, especially in a male patient. That's why here as well, very important. Observe privacy, be with a chaperone, and then adequate exposure, cleanliness, you clean up with saline. Sometimes if you are sure, you can still use diluted povidone, but sometimes if it is allergic, patient will suffer. Okay, after this washing and so on. Now here I would like to show you what are the equipments that we use. This is to wash your hand, and then afterwards actually we have to wash with the under tap water, soap and solution 1, 2, 3, something like that. After that you wipe it and then put on the glove. The way you put on the glove as well, okay, I will show you. I better use 7.5. Bigger one is easier for me. Okay, assuming that I have washed, I have scrub and I have dry up already. So how am I going to? Well, this one is a bit. Okay. Assuming that this is sterile, come here. My hand already washed, dry up. So I open up this way. Yeah, I have to use non-touch technique. That's me, I'm going to use left glove and open up, because these are undercover, going to be undercover, so I can touch with my bare hand. So once you push in here, okay, pull that much only. Afterwards to the other side. Now I with the glove and I can touch inside surface. Now here I'm going to push again with my right. Okay, now cover up already, and here as well, now I cover up already. Sorry, this one is not so, it's fragile. Okay, assuming that is already now intact, so this being done. Here you are seeing all the Foley's catheter with the different sizes, size 14 up to size 22. 22 is something like we call Russian size. No? For most of us, 16, 18, 20, just nice. For the boys, size 14. So accordingly, we will use the, so being double lumen, so here, assuming that, no? This one, okay. This one is sterile, assuming that. Okay, I will keep here, take it away. And my assistant may be helping me to open up this folded one. Here, I'm going to keep the sterile one, and this is the one. We call it draping. You want to? So before that, I'm going to wash, use this. And then here, watch from the center to periphery. Okay, I can push here. Center to periphery and so on. Few more times. After that, I can hold this part. So I have to be on the right side. Okay, please push here. Push this way. Okay, now. After washing, now I'm going to put this draping, usually green color. Okay. Keep here. Now I can hold with my left hand and lubricant. Where can I get? Oh, here. Assuming that. Okay, here. Pour already, yeah? Okay. But now what we do, that the real true condition, we use the anesthetic gel. We suck out from the tube anesthetic gel, maybe around 5-7 cc. Once we got it, I will pump here into that, pump into the urethra. And stop. And we have to clap with the stopa as well. There we shall have the stopa so that wait for some time. Till this anesthetic gel staying inside for some time already, anesthetized already, 5 to 10 minutes, something like that. After that only now, assuming that already anesthetized, now I'm going to push. This is already sterile, so I can push here. Very difficult. Something like this. Okay, that will be difficult. I know. So this tougher one, this one, tougher one I will use. Never mind. So I will pull this one. Okay. Okay, good. Near to the posterior urethra, there may be a little bit hindrance. There is difficulty to push in some more. That's why I suggested not to ask this catheterization question to our students. Because with the exam fright, as well as now, with this kind of difficulty, it is not advisable. Assuming that once in already, what we will do here, this is for the, okay, we'll put in the saline or water, about 7 cc. And then you just pump in. But be careful, we have to make sure that this balloon part already inside the bladder. Otherwise, it may stretch the posterior urethra and traumatize. Patient may have stricture later on. Okay, once sure, you pump in. So that balloon is already something like this. No? So even if with the air, you see, something like that. This is the balloon. No? So that it will stay inside, sucking up inside the urinary bladder, and you drain out through this into the back. So the back is here, ready. Okay, in the word, above this, usually the container above this, sometimes you see the measuring plastic boxes. Those are, we want to test urine output whether adequate or not. Okay, that's the way. So where we do need to do aseptic method, non-touch technique of putting on the cloth and everything. Well, that's how. So occasionally, once you have a chance, better see in the works. Anybody else, the doctor is doing catheterization. That's how. So after that, you wash and then keep away, cover up, and thanks to the patient, that's all. This is catheterization. Okay?